How's it going, gamers? I am Vast Game Master, and this is a SWAT 4 Elite Force mod tutorial. This isn't going to be a professional thing, but I am going to show you how to install most SWAT 4 mods, but specifically I'm going to show you how to install SWAT 4 Elite Force mod. So the first thing you got to do is to make sure you have your game folder up like so. Now, to find a game folder, you can either just go to your local C drive and type in SWAT4. And it'll usually take a minute or two to load up. But since it's taking a bit longer than expected, we're not going to be doing that. So, you just go to Programs 84 and then just type in SWAT, or look for a folder called SWAT4. Click on that and get that up. This is where you're going to be dropping your mods. Into. You're not going to be dropping them into these folders, you're going to be dropping them directly into this SWAT4 main folder. So, we have this up. Now, the next thing all you got to do is go to the website. On ModDB, you'll just look for a mod called SWAT4 Elite Force Mod. It'll be under Mods, and then you would just search it. Actually, I'll have a link in the description to where you can go here and download the mod and install it yourself. So scroll down here, there's going to be the files. Now, there's like different files. The only thing you want is the latest version. Right now, it's only version 6. So you want to just click this, click on download. Usually I'll say it's downloading or not. I'm also using Firefox, so you want to, if you don't have any way to open it up with a zip file, you can. But usually I use the WinRAR archiver. I usually just choose this to open a mod, but for the sake of this, I'm just going to save file. And if it's not downloading, since I'm using Firefox, you can see the little download icon. If it's not downloading, you just click this, and then it should like force the prompt a download, or it'll just start downloading. So it'll take some time to download. And while you're after you got that one downloaded, the next thing you need to download is the latest update for the mod. The Elite Force mod version 6 to 6.4 upgrade. And this is only for if you have the mod version 6. This is 6.4, which means this is the updated, and as of today, that's the most recent version out there right now until version 7 comes out. So, depending on the bandwidth, you might have to depending on your internet, it just depends. You might have to just download one mod at a time. So, I'll skip from here to when this thing is done downloading, and then we'll start going into how to install it. So, we have both mods downloaded now. And also, in case you guys are wondering how I get this little tab up with Firefox, all I did was go in here and it says, and click on this one. It says show all downloads, and you got that little tab that comes up. Now all you gotta do is click and drag all these to desktop. Okay, make sure you keep them separated too so you don't get them mixed up. Now we're just going to extract both files. Once you have the folder extracted, it'll be in this file called SCF. If you don't know where it is and you got this thing in a way, you can just minimize it, find it. Click on this and just click and drag over here. And that's all you're doing. You're just dropping it into this folder. Now we got this one installed, so now we're going to get the updated version, and we're going to install that one too. When you extract these files, they're going to be placed somewhere on your desktop. So if you don't know where they are, you just got to look for them. Look for a file called SEF. That's the mod that you're looking for. Okay. So we have both the mods. We have the mod installed and we have the update installed. Now, I want to show you a way where you can just launch the game directly. If you go, let me back up a bit. If you go into SEF folder, extras, right click on the launch SEF and then go to create desktop shortcut. Once you do that, it'll create a desktop shortcut like the one I got here. And then you can just place that anywhere. But for the sake of this tutorial, I'm just going to do it just to show you how it's done. And there you go. You got yourself a little desktop icon. And now, the game is basically installed. That's all there is to do. So all you gotta do is just click this and it'll start right up. I'm using Windows 10 version, so you might find other ones that uses Windows 7 or the earlier versions. But this is Windows 10, in case anybody's wondering if you could still run this on Windows 10. Yeah, you can. You certainly can. I'm not sure if it's any different with the game on GOG.com, but this is pretty much like a standalone version. It's not installed from GOG.com. It's something that I got from somewhere else. There you go. The game runs. Change the settings. And the music is really loud. I'm just turning the music down. And there you go. Then all you gotta do is set it to the resolution to your monitor. Resolution. Click yes. And there you go. If you go higher than 1280 by 960 or 7 or 1024, for some reason the text will disappear. That is not your fault. It's just that's just how the game engine is. It's pretty old. It's aged over the years. It can't even adapt to current monitors though. But if you're fine with it, then there's nothing to worry about. Most of the time, if you just put your mouse cursor over this, you'll have like a little text thing that comes up on the bottom left. That tells you what it is anyway. And that's all there is to it. So let me just jump into the game. It kind of give you a demonstration that it works 100%. So I'll just start something different. Let's see, we'll call it example. We'll create a career.
Central BCC to Adam Boyd.
Residence. Got the briefing, all that stuff, yada yada yada. Then we jump in. And that's all there is to it. And this is how you're going to install mods for SWAT 4 from this point on. And there's other mod videos out there that tells you how to install it in this fashion. And it's always different. But usually the method is still the same. It's not going to be like any... Like, it's not going to really make a difference how you do it as long as it still works. You could also just put the zip file inside the SWAT 4 folder and then just extract it there, or you could just put it on desktop. It's whatever you want to do. Also, these skins for these officers don't come with the mod. These are just my own personal skins that I made for these officers myself, so yours is going to look different. You'll have like one team that's wearing black and the other team that's wearing blue, and they don't have these skull masks on there. These are just textures that I made. They're kind of private. It's a private, like, skin mod that I made for these guys. And that's all there is to it. So now you got... Now you're ready to play. You're ready to enjoy the game. And that concludes the tutorial. If you guys found this helpful, make sure you leave a like. And if you really, really did like this tutorial and you found this really, like, I don't know, life-saving in some way, which it's not that big of a deal, then you can consider like leaving a subscribe or go check out one of my other videos. I've made a couple of videos of me playing SWAT 4. One was showcasing the mod and demonstrating it, and the other ones are just playthroughs of it. I also have other videos of playthroughs that I do on my channel, so make sure you go check that out, and if you want to subscribe, go ahead and do so. Like, comment, share, and have a good one, and happy hunting.